الحمد لله واحد الديان مبت لكيد السحرة والمنجمين والكهان المخالفين لشريعة الخير الأنام والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد. قال نبي الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اجتنبوا سبع الموبقات: الشرك بالله والسحر. أما بعد, human beings, they worry too much about a problem or danger which is very, very far away from them. But in reality, the danger is right close behind them. They are not even worried. They are not even taking heed. A lot of people are neglecting this danger. This danger is serious. And you have to take it serious. You have to know your enemy, how he thinks, and what does he want, what he loves, what he hates. And who is that enemy? The enemy is the Qarin. Today I'm going to narrate to you about the Qarin. The Qarin are in three types. The Jinn, the one who calls upon you to do evil, the devil. And the angel is the one who calls, whispers to you and to do good. And the third Qarin is the angel, is the one who writes the good and the evil. Now this devil Qarin is the son of Iblis. Just like Allah Rabbul Izzah given Iblis, La'natullah, to be the Qarin of Adam alayhi salam. So every human being has a devil Qarin from the Iblis progeny. The minute you are born, you have that companion until you die. His job, one thing alone, mislead. And he has misled a lot. His job is to whisper. And he uses the whisper effectively. While you hear some people say they don't get whisper at all. They are either lying to themselves or they don't agree with the speech of Allah Rabbul Izzah, what he narrate to us. And what is that? Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوسه بنفسه. We've created man and we know what thoughts come to him. This is what Allah Rabbul Izzah says. Allah Rabbul Izzah mentioned the word Qarin in the Quran 7 times. That is how serious this matter is. If you see a matter which has been repeated so many times in the Quran, you should take heed. The companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam complained so much about the thoughts and the whispers which are bombarding them. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, praise be to Allah Rabbul Izzah that he has made the plot of the devil as whisper alone. Human beings, all of them have definitely a companion. There's no doubt about that. The angel and the devil. The devil Qarin, his mission is to destroy you. Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ومن يكون الشيطان له قرينا فساء قرينا. Whoever has taken the shaitan as his companion, what an evil companion he has taken. The evil devil Qarin will only incite you to do evil. And he will love it if you are an evil person. He will tell you, go and commit zina. Go and do riba. Go and eat haram. Go and do sihr. Go and do this. Stay away from halal. He will beautify you, the evil. You think it's yourself. But now this devil has become your friend. You can't cut the shackles. But there is a way to cut these shackles. On the day of judgment, the human and the jinn Qarin will have a dialogue. We start complaining to Allah Rabbul Izzah. While in fact, the individual himself was a devil. And the devil misled him more. The dialogue will happen between human being and the devil. But the devil are around us many. The issue is not the devil. The issue is ourselves. It is how the Qarin has an impact on the individual. If your iman is strong and your reliance upon Allah is strong, you will have an impact on this Qarin. Just like Umar bin Khattab, radiallahu anh, his iman was strong. The devil, when he sees him on the road, he flees. The question is how to make your iman strong. Read Quran, pray tahajjud, pray your 5 salah, adhkar, sadaqah, help Muslims. This will build your iman and ask Allah to guide you and protect you. And the Qarin will have nothing to do with you. You will defeat him. But if you eat haram, you do haram, the Qarin will have the upper hand. Now the question again rises, do they do magic on the Qarin? The answer is yes, they do magic on the Qarin. Because the shaitan, jinn, human being or the devil does not get information of yours until they pass towards the Qarin and they get all your information. The Qarin devil. And this type of magic, they do it in 2 ways. They do it on the human being and they do it on the Qarin himself, the devil Qarin. Because the source of magic is from the shaitan. Shaitan himself, he does magic. That's why they can do it on the jinn and they can do it on the human being. And the Qarin knows more of you than anybody else. Now, how do they do this type of magic? They do it to the Qarin and they do it to you. They either use your name, your mother's name, or your address. Or they can use more stuff. And when does it hit the individual, this magic of the Qarin? When the individual is grieving too much, when the individual is very angry, when the individual is crying too much and going to the bed while crying, this is the time when they pounce and do their magic to you and the Qarin. Allah knows best. And this magic will either be to separate or to cause sickness, to cause madness, to have too many waswasa, bipolar, either to cause craziness, sexlophenia. Every disease is to do with the brain. They will do it through the Qarin. What are the symptoms and the sign of this magic? If you have these signs, know that you've been hit by the magic of the Qarin. Overwhelming whispers and doubt, too much, yawning too much when hearing the Quran, pain in the left-hand side of the body, from the belly all the way to the up, to the shoulder, all the way to the hands, pain always. When the individual get a ruqya done on him, there will be no reaction, but the individual will cry. Tears will be coming out from him, very light tears. This differs as well. It could be also evil eye. How to treat this problem? You have to wipe haram. You have to seek isti'ana towards Allah. You have to call upon Allah, dua. You have to pray 5 times. You have to read adhkar morning, evening. And get rose water and get black seed oil and olive oil. And read Surah Al-Takwir, Surah Yasin, Surah Al-Kahf, morning, afternoon and evening. And read Surah Al-Ikhlas, read the Mu'awwidhatain, plus these 3 surahs I've mentioned. And ayatul sihr, when ayah should be sufficient, and qul ya ayyuhal kafirun. It is very important that surah to be read. Read on the olive oil, read on the black seed oil. In the morning, have 3 drops of black seed oil and the rose water, half of a cup, drink it. And in the evening, drink it for a minimum of 6 months. And the black seed oil and the olive oil, mix it together. Apply it every night and every morning when you're going to bed in the night and in the morning when you wake, you know. Apply it for a minimum of 6 months. Don't stop. Do this treatment and be patient. You will be better. وآخر دعوانا وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.